Hi, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to set up a secure VPN server on AWS EC2 using a free and secure AMI from AWS Marketplace. The best part? You can run this server with almost no cost because the free tier EC2 instance should be sufficient for home use. The AMI we'll be using is already configured and doesn't incur any additional charges. So if you are not too technical, this makes things way easier. We'll skip the steps you'd normally have to set up manually. Images from the marketplace have this advantage that in most cases they are already configured, up to date and truly secured. Don't worry, I will tell you which one you should choose and why. But before we dive into the setup, I will go over some of the ways you can use a VPN server like this. And at the end, I will show you how to add MFA to VPN to make it even more secure. So, VPN or Virtual Private Network is a fantastic tool that enables secure connection to network resources. Here are some examples of how you can use it. Remote access to resources and applications. You can connect remotely to your own resources in AWS, like databases or applications, using a secure connection. VPN also allows you to create a safe tunnels for communication between cloud-based applications, making it possible to carry out tests and operations without worrying about data security. Because you know, not everybody wants to pay a bag of money for a direct connect from their own houses to the cloud. And it's not always necessary, because VPN is also a really good security. Secure internet browsing. VPN protects your data and privacy while browsing the internet, especially on public Wi-Fi networks. Bypassing geographic restrictions. You can access content that is available only in certain countries, like streaming services. You may not know, but a lot of information is blocked in various countries. Using a VPN, you can bypass these restrictions. Of course, I'm not encouraging you to break the law, but I'm telling you about the possibilities that VPN offers. Global testing flexibility. You can create VPN server in various regions across the globe. This gives you the ability to use its regional IP address to test your applications, simulation user access from specific locations, and providing insights into app performance across different areas. Connection security. Of course, with VPN you can encrypt your connection, making it much harder for third parties to intercept your data. But before we dive into setting a Lambda function, I want to show you how to configure security group rules and select appropriate ports, explaining each choice. For security reason, I will set up access only for my current IP address. This approach is generally recommended for personal or home use, where access is usually limited to known devices. Manually adding just your own IP address keeps connections secure and minimizes exposure to unknown sources. But it might require updates if your IP changes or if you need to log in from a different location, such as hotel. In that case, you can quickly log to AWS console and add a new IP address. For a VPN server on EC2, the following ports are essential. 443. This is the standard port for HTTPS traffic, allowing secure connections to the VPN. 1194. This is default port for OpenVPN. 943. Used for accessing the OpenVPN admin web UI, where you can manage and configure the VPN. 22. Necessary for SSH access, allowing secure remote management of the EC2 instance. By restricting access just to these ports and controlling which IP are permitted, you can create a secure and functional configuration for connecting to your VPN and managing your server. Create security group, add some name. 4. A VPN server on EC2, the following ports are essential. 22 is necessary for SSH access, allowing secure remote management of the EC2 instance. 443, this is the standard port for HTTPS traffic, allowing secure connections to the VPN. 943 is used for accessing the OpenVPN admin web UI, where you can manage the configuration of the VPN. 1194, the default port for OpenVPN. Now, for every line, choose source, my IP, and create security group. Now we can go to EC2. Add some name, for example, OpenVPN. Browse more AMIs and type OpenVPN. Choose AWS Marketplace AMIs and choose OpenVPN Access Server Self-Hosted VPN. Don't choose 10 connected devices. This one. It's a good choice and it's legit because it's created by OpenVPN ENC. Go to pricing. As you can see, there is no cost for AMI, just for EC2. And you can change for something cheaper. Let's go to product details and oh yeah, here it is. Without a subscription key installed, OpenVPN Access Server will allow two concurrent connections at no additional cost, excepting AWS infrastructure cost. Subscribe now. Instance type, choose T2 micro, free tier eligible. Keeper, you can choose your keeper or create a new one. I create new one. Open VPN and create keeper. Network settings, choose your subnet, auto-assign public IP should be enabled, select existing security group, and choose that group you created before, in my case it's OpenVPN security group. And launch instance, okay, this can take a while, so you can drink your coffee. Okay. Let's go to EC2. Let's wait a moment. Connect. Choose SSH client. Copy this example. Okay, open folder with your key. Type cmd. Yep, perfect. And paste the example. Of course, you should login as OpenVPN AS greater than root user. So let's change this. Enter. Oh yeah. Okay, maybe if I make it bigger, the window will be more readable. Oh, yeah, it's better. If you agree with license, type yes. Okay, that's my primary access server, so I type yes. Type no if you want to create backup or standby node. Default is 1 and this is a good choice for me because I want to use all my interfaces for my admin web UI. Choose algorithms you want to use for OpenVPN. Default is okay. By the way, you have the higher security than RSA. The same algorithm for self-signed web certificate. Default is the same. Okay, now choose port for admin web UI. Default is 493. And we set the same in security group. Choose TCP port for OpenVPN daemon. 443 is default, and we also set this in security group. And here, if you select yes, all your traffic will go through VPN. Don't worry, you can change this later. Also the same for DNS traffic. Yes, I want access to my private subnet. Okay, I want to log into admin UI as OpenVPN. So yes, and now you can create password for OpenVPN user. If you left blank, a random password will be generated. Okay. Okay, leave blank. Enter. Okay, it's ready. Okay, now we can test this. Okay, let's log into admin UI, copy this line. Paste in a browser. Yeah, don't worry. Advanced. And let's go to our VPN. Now, login as OpenVPN and your password. Sign in. Agree. Oh yeah, as you can see, two VPN connections allowed. Okay, you can go to VPN settings. Okay, you can check if all traffic will be routed through VPN and DNS. As I mentioned earlier, if you haven't set up this on the beginning or you want to change it, this is a place for this. Okay, now we can set up the MFA. Go to authentication settings and here it is, multi-factor authentication. Just change from no to yes. Save settings and update running server. Okay. So you can log in again. OpenVPN password. Signed in. And oh yeah. Multi-factor authentication. Okay, now you can scan your QR code and set up MFA. Okay, now you can just open your app, scan the QR code and enter the 6-digit code. Confirm choice and yeah, it's ready. Okay, now I install VPN client for my Windows machine. I choose Windows because now I use Windows. As you can see, you have also clients for macOS, Linux, Windows, iOS, Android, and so on, yeah. Okay, download, open. Yeah, never mind. Run anyway. Next. I accept the license, next install. Oh, yeah. Finish. Okay, agree, and let's turn on VPN. Okay, that's my profile for OpenVPN on my EC2. My password. Okay, and code from authentication app. Send. Oh, yeah. And connected. How to check if it works? You can, for example, write what is my IP. And this is not my home IP. This is IP from my EC2. Yep, identical. So thanks for watching and see you in the next video.